me the scripture found in St. Matthew 9, 20 and 21.
Thank you, Jesus.
It is familiar about the woman with the issue of blood. And it says here, and behold, the woman was with disease with the issue of blood for 12 years, came behind him and touched him, the hem of his garment. Amen. So you see here, this woman had the issue of blood for 12 years. And 2 Timothy 2:15 says, study to show yourself approved, rightly divine the word of truth, but need not be ashamed. Amen.
Amen.
So what happened, that word says is, some of the word is for the children of Israel. Some of the word is for the people, and some of this word is for the church. We always can not check the hem of his garment. So this word goes to the church. Then I did my math and I studied, and I found out that in her 12-year issue of this blood and his 3-year ministry, they collided. Now, she's like us. She had 11 and 12 years of her issue, and I consider it not to be a female issue, but I consider it to be a human issue. Yeah. You know, when you have a nosebleed, it will come at the worst time. If you sit among your friends and then your nose bleed, you be laughing, or you might just move the wrong way. That's an issue. It's an issue for us today. We see blood come out of somebody. You know the issue of blood. We don't mess with no blood now. Imagine 2,000 years ago. And the Bible says she had money. She spent all that she had. So she was well off. Like a lot of us, we were well off, and we don't need Jesus. So you see, what happened is she knew that he was a healer. But because of education, because of position in society, because of my celebrity status, I don't need no Jesus. She knew that he was a healer, but I'm going to still go to the false. I'm going to still go to the false, not going to the right one. So here we have this lady that is colliding. Now she's going to spend all she had. And how did she touch the hem of his garment? How was she able to touch Christ?
Yes, yes.
The Bible says, he said, who touched me? So he didn't know who it was. Let me explain. The word kenosis is a Greek word. It's related to his dual identity, his divinity, and his humanity. He was half man, half amazing.
Hallelujah.
He was 100% man, 100% God.
Hallelujah.
He was the God manifested in the flesh. And you see why he was on pursuit of humanity, because a man would say, my daughter died, she's dead. And Jesus said, she sleepeth. Yes. So that was his humanity.
Hallelujah.
But behind him, the woman with the issue of blood on pursuit, she touched the divinity. That's what happened forward.
Yes.
You touched the divinity.
Yes.
And he didn't know who it was.
Yes.
And he at Bethel and the rift and make that mission, we call that backdoor blessing. Because, you know, Boo Boo and Kiki might need to pray for them, but they don't want to come to the church.
Come on, man.
Because the Bible said the prayers of the righteous avail much.
Right.
And because you pray, God gonna move.
Yes.
Now you pray for Boo Boo, and Boo Boo said, you know, get Boo Boo out of jail. I ain't praying for Boo Boo to run faster from the cops and Kiki for the hustle men. Now you won't be a sinner, and you won't be bad about it. Be a man about it. Come to the Lord.
Come on,
now. Be a woman about it. Come to the Lord.
Come on.
So she snuck up on Jesus, and we want Jesus to know it's us.
Right.
And you need to pray. See, Jesus is the door.
Yes.
Not the back door.
Yeah,
he is the door. And any man knocking, he will open it.
Yeah,
we don't believe in no back door blessing.
Yes.
You feel me? You know what I'm saying? And see, that's why it's recorded in the Bible. Because who is this woman?
Right.
And you can touch my sickness. His humanity before him.
Right.
So she's sneaking. But he said to the Samaritan woman, it's not fit to give the bread to the children of God to the dogs.
Yeah.
Do you still believe in Jesus as a savior? Why is it a hookup? Amen?
Yes.
Who are you? Who touched me?
Yes.
So careful when you say, if I can touch the hem of his garment, then you gotta take the whole role and say, I'm a sneak. And I'm a backdoor blesser. I want to bring you to sneak a blessing.
Yeah.
You understand? Be careful when you say, can I touch the hem of his garment? Amen. You will be a man about yours. You will be a woman about yours. I need help.
Yes.
I need you, Jesus.
Yes.
Don't be praying. Pray for me. Are you saved? Pray for me. You're pushing the other saints up.
Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
Bring somebody to elder. I'll make sure that you pray.
Right.
If you pray, then I'll pray with you. It's a touch and agree.
Yeah.
I'm not going to pray for people who get more weak.
Right.
And if be the middle word of life, and if been a problem for you, all you got to do is look eternal, which is Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
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 Listen here. Elder got a gift.
Yeah.
Oh, elder got a gift.
Hallelujah.
Y'all got it for y'all. The top of the 80s. Just been released out of prison. Grand larceny, drug trafficking, assault battery, drug using, all of it. My parents and people told me don't come back. So I came out of jail, 2 weeks out of jail. I'm homeless. All I got is my Tims, my jeans, and my hoodie. I'm a menace to society. I'm a threat. Yeah, I've been serving the devil a long time. And I'm sitting across the street from this church. And I remember sitting on this stoop. And to wind it back a little bit, my grandfather, Elder Robert McKnight, who started McKnight Ministries in 1940,
right.
My grandmother told me I was going to take over the ministry when I was young. Oh, you like my husband. Not like my dad, which is her first son, but I'm like her husband. She said, come be the third. Come be the third. You will take over the ministry. My grandfather was an elder. He was a farmer and a carpenter. So who, how can I fill his shoes? So here I'm out of prison 2 weeks, and I remember that prophecy, and I looked at the church at the stoop, and I said, one day I'm going to go to that church. But I was feeling kind of tight that day. It was 2 weeks of my hair was, you know, 2 weeks being out. I was homeless. I was eating at soup kitchens, and I was feeling tight. I didn't get high. I didn't drink. I was clean. I didn't look it, but I was clean. So I'm sitting on the stoop, and I said, yeah, I'm getting hungry, and I want to get some money. I'm going to fight a man for his one-on-one. My mind was saying that. I was getting delirious. You know, I was never fight a man for his wallet, his jewelry, and one-on-one best man. And something in my